guys, Clint here with Classic Firearms, coming at you guys today from another video done inside the bunker here. And it's not just because it's bad weather outside, but it's because we're here to have a little bit more of a open discussion, if you will, about home defense options when it comes to selecting a home defense firearm. So let's go ahead and dive right into it. And I'm just gonna go ahead and say top five firearm styles we'll take a look at as far as home defense options. And the first one I'm gonna go with is a pistol, all right? Because everybody kind of considers a pistol to be a pretty good idea when it comes to home defense, close quarters, around doorways, everything else like that, whenever needing to clear a house. Something like this is just the way to go. And the one that I like a whole lot is the Beretta M9A3, which we do have available on our site right now. Make sure too that you're looking under the correct SKU, because this guy is still at an amazing price, but a lot of you guys I think are looking at a different model, a different variation, because there are several different models of the M9A3 out there. Make sure you're looking at the one that in the description straight up says has night sights. And it does have the Trijicon night sights on it, which I am a huge fan of, by the way. And 17 round mag capacity, coming with three mags also. Yeah, that's pretty sweet, all right? Anyway, when it comes to a home defense situation though, most of the time where my mind goes, and let me know down in the comments, like I said, it's gonna be more of a discussion. I wanna hear what you guys' thoughts and opinions are, because hey, I can learn from y'all too. When it comes to the home defense scenario, I typically imagine nighttime, things like that. So I'm usually rocking a pistol light, just like you see right here. And also I typically want to have a firearm that does have night sights equipped. Now, of course, some firearms come out there with, you know, standard sights that aren't, you know, luminescent or anything like that. No big deal, that's fine. I typically like to look for a firearm that has dovetails, things like that, where I can knock them out and replace the sights myself if need be. And what's nice about the Beretta M9A3 is the fact that it already comes with that. And like I said, make sure you're looking at the right SKU, and you won't have an issue determining which product it is that you're looking for if you sign up for our emails, because we'll tell you which one it is exactly, the price too low to show, all that stuff that you guys see on there. Yeah, we'll have the link sent directly to your inbox. Can't go wrong there, right? Anyway, so I definitely recommend something along the lines night sights, pistol mounted light that you see again right here. Big fan of that. And besides that, there's not much anything else that I've done to this firearm. It came with the night sights. All I've done is slapped on this light, right? Now, of course, this one's chambered in 9mm. There's other options out there. And another great one that I like a whole lot, and this is more one that I preferably carry on the range, you know, open carry all the time, because it's such a big, hefty guy. And this is the FNX 45 Tactical. And I've got a Trijicon RMR on mine. Again, suppressor height, Trijicon night sights as well. Threaded barrel, both of these have threaded barrels, a little bit extra length there. Increases the velocity just a little bit, but you can suppress them if you want. But actually, before I go any further, when it comes to suppressors in a home defense situation, I personally wouldn't recommend it. A lot of you guys might be thinking, wait, what? Why not? Because you're indoors, you're gonna be blowing your ears out. Yeah, well, that might be the case. However, I want my neighbors, I want everybody close to me knowing that there's something bad happening in my house, and they can get the police over here if I'm too busy defending my life or my wife or whatever else it might be, and I don't have time to dial 911. I don't know what the situation is. However, more people to show up and help, the better, right? Hopefully it doesn't complicate things, but if law enforcement shows up and that's due to my neighbors hearing all sorts of crazy crap happening in my house, sweet, more power to them, all right? Anyway, we've got these FNX 45 Tacticals, which I am a huge fan of. I've loved shooting these guys, 15 round mag capacity and 45 ACP, sweet. And a heck of a lot of fun and easy to shoot, right? Now, the downside to having a pistol when it comes to home defense is accuracy, right? It might be something a little bit more to manipulate and get used to when shooting. So, of course, you definitely should get the training, and I think that's probably the biggest part whenever it comes to home defense or just self-defense, whatever it might be. Without proper training, you can have all the tools in the world. If you don't know how to use them, well, you're kind of up that creek without a paddle, you know what I mean? So take that into consideration. Red dots on pistols too, I am a fan of. They do take a little bit of getting used to, however, definitely train with yours, get used to it. Again, in a low light setting, definitely a good thing to have. If you can't pick up, you know, your night sights, or let's just say you don't have night sights on your firearm and you've got a red dot, then that's definitely a heck of a lot better than not being able to see your sights at all, right? So FNX 45 Tactical comes standard with the night sights, and we've also got the ones that have the Viper optic on it as well by Vortex, and they make some pretty sweet stuff. So highly recommend both of those. So pistols, I do believe, make a great option. Just like with every other firearm I'm gonna talk about here though, just get that training to make sure that you actually know how to manipulate, use, and you're efficient with your pistol, because if not, what good is it, right? All right, continuing on, and again, like I said, this is more of a discussion. I wanna hear all of your thoughts down below as well, and let's talk about it some. Maybe you guys are like, hey, that's a terrible setup. Why would you go with that? Constructive criticism is always accepted. You guys just bashing other people down in the comments, or myself. Yeah, I'll just mull right over that. Anyway, let's carry on. While we're talking about pistols, let's just move right on. Now, this is my CZ Scorpion. I'm just having this as an example as a pistol caliber carbine that you can use. Carbine used loosely here because it's still considered a pistol by ATF standards. However, mine is full-time suppressed. So pretty much what I said before, this isn't a gun that I typically have set up as like a bedside situation, whatever. This is a fun gun for me, a backpack style gun that I just really enjoy taking to the range and shooting. However, let's just say I take the can off this guy and I'm not blowing my rail to pieces because I have a short barrel under here. Let's say that this guy here has a longer barrel on it, or maybe I just actually take my rail off and put the original rail back on and have the K model set up. A pistol caliber carbine, now we're talking, I think, for personally, again, I wanna hear everybody's comments down below, I think would make a great home defense option. You've got pistol cartridges, so you don't have to worry about over penetration, you know, trying to defend your life, and next thing you know, your neighbors have a couple of new holes in their house or something. Not a good day, right? So be considerate of what type of ammunition you're using. Hollow points, things like that, not a bad idea to use inside of a close quarter setup like your house. All right, now what's great about a pistol caliber carbine setup, again, carbine quotes, is the fact that you can get that third point of contact, right, and have a little bit better accuracy with it, okay? Accuracy is everything, right? Fast is fine, but accuracy is everything. Just take that into consideration, okay? Now, with a pistol, you might have a couple of other controls, things like that. It's not simply always safe. Sometimes you need to rack around in there. You technically already should have a round, you know, carry one in the chamber, just do yourself a favor, save yourself some time. Same thing that goes with this guy here. Having that round in the chamber, you're ready, flip it off, you know, flip it onto fire, ready mode here, and now you're aiming down your sights. Now you'll notice too that I actually have the Streamlight TLR2. Check out Streamlight products on our website too, make great stuff. This right here is a laser light combo, which again, you might be able to pick that up there. again, is a great option for nighttime setup. The laser, you don't have to really be aiming down your sights. Point of aim, point of impact. Pretty sweet, right? As long as it's zeroed. If it's not zeroed, then maybe you're hitting in that general vicinity. Again, you gotta train with the firearms that you plan on using. If you don't, and you don't know your system that well, then what good is it, right? Who knows? And also too, I mentioned hollow points before. If you're gonna be using hollow points defensively, or whatever other type of load you wanna carry defensively, make sure it actually shoots through your gun. Take a couple of mags, run that ammo that you use to defend yourself with through your gun at the range. Save yourself a headache later on, because if you find out that maybe your gun doesn't like to feed hollow points and here you are in a life or death situation and you've got a round just sitting there getting blocked and it's just not going, you're not feeding, and well, now you've just got yourself something you can throw, I guess. I don't know. But anyway, I do believe a pistol caliber carbine set up like this right here would be a great option. Magpul makes great mags for the CZ Scorpion, 35 round mag capacity. So you've already got one heck of a lot more capacity than you would on your standard pistol setup. So again, 17 rounds, 15 rounds, my Glock over here, 15 rounds, that Beretta there, I think it's 13. So now you've jumped that up to 35, 32 rounds, I think is what the standard capacity is for the Scorpion, or the regular mags. But then again, you've also got to take into consideration your laws that you have to abide by as well, because you don't want to be in a situation where you're doing some shooting and then all of a sudden to come to find out, hey, How many rounds did you have in your mag? Because in this state, you can only have 10. Did you have 12? Now all of a sudden, who's the victim, right? I know, it's things you have to really take into consideration. So make sure that you get the proper training, you know your state and federal laws, so that way things don't come back on you negatively if you ever find yourself in already a bad situation, all right? All right, continuing on here, also to, again, pistol caliber carbine setup, the Brigade BM9 that we carry. Love that little, they got rifles, pistols, everything. Love that setup, always a heck of a lot of fun to shoot. And again, it's easy to control, easy to maintain that accuracy, right? Firing multiple rounds downrange at the same spot or at the same target isn't hard to do. You don't have to worry about a whole lot of recoil and, you know, trying to hit your target, right? Pretty nice whenever it comes to these pistol calibers. So, sweet. Downside about these guys, I can't really think of a whole lot. Again, I would say, you know, power, right? But you don't want over penetration in that close quarters. So, me, I think a, you know, a pistol caliber setup like this right here would be an excellent choice for home defense. Again, you need to be accurate though. We're gonna have to be accurate with all of these systems, no matter what people say. But this is exactly what I'm thinking about. So anyway, let me know again your thoughts and comments down below. I'd like to hear them, all right? And now let's continue this train right on here. Next setup is probably gonna be a pretty popular one, I think, and that's your AR-15 platform, whether it be, you know, full-on 16-inch barrel, short-barreled rifle like I've got going on here. First thing that comes to mind though, whenever I start talking about rifles for home defense, if you're in a neighborhood, best advice is probably just don't do it, all right? Now granted, depending on what type of ammunition you use, use frangible ammunition, stuff that doesn't have, you know, overpowering penetration through it, okay, not a bad idea. For me, hey, I like this right here. This is my Daniel Defense Mark 18 with a 60 round drum mag. Why? Because if you can go 60 rounds, 70, 100, whatever it might be, go for it. You don't have to worry about trucking it a whole lot of way. If it's a little bit heavier, so be it, because the furthest you're probably gonna go is somewhere around your house. You don't have to carry a whole lot of ammunition. And a 30 round mag, sure, that's nice. But if you got a 60 round drum that's effective and efficient and actually works, love it, right? Magpul D60, good stuff. All right, so pros about the AR-15 as being a home defense setup. Now, I would say definitely pros, you've got the power, right? You've got the capability, you got the knockdown power, sure. Things like that are great. You've got the accuracy, you've got ease of use, and of course, being able to shoulder a full-on rifle like this is the way to go. I would say, however, a setup like this, being a short-barreled rifle or maybe even a pistol configuration, they make the Mark 18 in a pistol, they make all sorts of ARs in a pistol configuration, would be a great way to go. You'll notice, however, I've got a couple of things on here to make my life a little bit easier in low-light settings. For one, a flashlight. Flashlights are great. Again, Streamlight with a pressure pad here makes it very easy to actuate if I'm aiming wherever, okay? You see that there? And then I have an instant on as well. Very cool, or a stay on, permanent on, whatever you want to call it. I've also got a red dot sight on it. My iron sights that I have as backups that co-witness with my EOTech here do not have any type of luminescent on it. So during daylight operations or whatever, hey, those are just fine, but typically at night, the battery lasts pretty good on this guy, even though it does take a CR123, so a little pricey and have to replace it. Just get it to a setting, go into a dark setting, turn on your red dot, see if it doesn't wash out everything, if it doesn't get too grainy or pixelated or whatever else, because you'll notice if you sight this guy in and you're like, all right, cool, that's a perfect red dot for daylight hours, and then you go into nighttime operations and then all of a sudden it's like, oh wow, all I see is my red dot, right? So make sure it actually works well for you at nighttime when you might be using it. Never know though, so again, just keep that in mind. Daylight break-ins, things like that, they do happen. It's an occurrence. It's something that's not uncommon. So the best thing to do is just be ready, be trained. All right. Now, as I mentioned before, AR-15 shooting the 5.56 223 caliber has the potential to over-penetrate, and now your bullet is traveling directions you probably don't want it to go, or it's going further than you need it to go or want it to go. So you got to be able to account for every round that is sent downrange, okay? So keep that in mind if you're choosing, you know, something with a little bit higher velocity, a larger caliber as a home defense option, all right? All right, and continuing on here. All right, and then we've got the ever popular shotgun, right? Everybody just thinks, man, shotgun's the way to go. You don't have to aim down your sights. The only sound you have to make is a, and you don't have to worry about bad guys because everybody knows that universal language. Guys, yes, you do have to aim, and don't count on this sound to deter any type of bad situation, all right? Just keep in mind that you do have a shotgun. If you and your, let's say you're in a family, right? This is a scenario I'm just throwing out here. Maybe you're the only person in your family that knows how to operate a shotgun. I have taken many people to the range. Hey, let's go shoot a shotgun. And how many times have they seen in the movies or anything else where they have to cock it to load the next shell, right? After they pull the trigger. You won't believe how many times I've seen somebody go aim down range, pull, and then they go to pull the trigger again and again. Hey, it's not working. We'll pump it. Oh, okay, all right, pop, then they get it. Now put that person in a high stress situation. Now all of a sudden, oh crap, I gotta pump it every time. Oh man, that, okay, all right, cool. And then you get that myth in your head, well, I don't really have to aim. I'm, you know, the spread on this guy is gonna go crazy, right? Not necessarily. If you're engaging your target within about 10 to 20 feet, the amount of spread you're getting is about maybe about the size of my fist, depending on what type of load you're using. So you're still gonna have to aim. And with that being said, you still have to consider what load you're using. If it's buckshot, that still has a pretty good potential of penetrating, you gotta think. Slugs, yeah. Birdshot, okay, all right, cool, I see where you're coming from, but the lethality of that's not that great for a human type of thing. So all of this stuff you have to take into consideration with a shotgun. Now, I will say that a shotgun, I do believe, is a great home defense setup if you are familiar with it, you're efficient with it, you know what you're loading, because, I don't know, I've got all sorts of different loads on here, right? I've got buckshot here, birdshot here, all right? And typically I just keep buckshot loaded in this guy. That's just my preference. Again, you guys can leave whatever comments you want down below, but I will just say this, you guys, I don't think you know exactly my living situation or how far my neighbors are, so whatever comments you have, just keep that in mind, I guess. But anyway, I would like to read them and be involved in this, in the conversation with me, so please be involved. Anyway, shotguns again are great, but look at the length of this guy. If you did have to turn a corner in your house, you might be scraping up your wall a little bit, which, hey, who gives a crap at the wall at this point? But the thing is, though, that might be throwing you off completely. You're doing this number, trying to just get a sight picture, and, well, your wall is keeping you from doing that, or you're hitting a threshold, or who knows what you're doing with this long boy in your arms. So I would say that a shotgun, though, it is a good idea. Maybe if you're just stationary, waiting in your bedroom, you've got a hallway leading to it, who knows, right? Maybe. Just maybe. So I am actually not the biggest fan of a shotgun for home defense, me personally. Again, you guys can say what you want, let me know your thoughts, but do I think they serve a purpose? Absolutely. Do I love shotguns? Heck yeah. But I typically don't keep one next to my bed, I'll be honest with you guys. So though I think they're great for other situations, things like this, maybe your full-size pump action like this Remington 870 isn't the best. Now, there are shorter pump actions out there, which I think would be great, but I also just try to keep that in mind too for new shooters, things along those lines. You'd have to really get used to this guy. And if you're not used to the recoil of a 12-gauge shotgun, it might actually throw you off a little bit, especially if you're already in a high-stress situation. So just things to try to take into consideration, all right? Now, there are other types of shotguns out there that might make things a little bit easier for you, like the Panzer BP-12. So a little bit different platform. This guy's a bullpup design and it's magazine fed. This guy right here has a tube fed magazine. I think it's 6+1 that I could put on this guy, and that means 6 in the tube, 1 in the chamber. Very cool. So I've got 7 rounds. That's only 7 shots before I need to start reloading. So again, just other things to keep into consideration, all right? But if you have something like the BP-12 here that's magazine fed, it's only got 5 shots in the magazine, but it's a whole lot easier to switch out this magazine than it is to start loading up shells. Granted, depends on how efficient you are with the platform that you're using, right? So it makes sense. But what's cool about something like this, chambered in 12 gauge still, takes the 3-inch magnum loads if you want them, just like my Remington here does. But it being that bullpup design, I mean, let's just go ahead and look at our profile here. Here's the bullpup. Right, little bit shorter. I could easily maneuver this within a house if I need to, not bad. And then you've got your full length shotgun here, right? If you get to know your firearm, you might be able to maneuver it just fine. However, I think this just makes it a lot easier for a lot of people, okay? So check out the BP-12, and I know these are very popular for us, so if they're not currently in stock while viewing this, go ahead and hit that little, you know, product notification here, notify me when it's back in stock, and you'll guys get an email the moment that these do come back in stock, and you'll be able to pick yours up then, if you're waiting for one. But the BP-12 is a really cool shotgun. It's got AR style controls to it, which are very nice, ambi safety. And so it's just an easy shotgun to familiarize yourself with if you've already familiarized yourself with the AR-15 platform. So just something to, again, take into consideration when it comes to, you know, getting used to the firearm that you'll be using, right? But I think ultimately the takeaway from this video is here, and if you disagree with me, again, let me know. But training and familiarizing yourself with whatever type of platform you want it to be, whether it be a semi-auto, a revolver even, if it's what you have and you know how to use it efficiently, then more power to you. That's the way it should be. That's awesome. Who am I to tell you guys what you should or shouldn't use? It's whatever you're most comfortable with. And if it's a BP-12, a full-length, you know, shotgun, like again, the 870, Mossberg 500, we had those Akar Churchill shotguns, which were really great. I actually like those quite a bit. Pistols, pistol caliber carbines. Again, I put quotations because that's still designated as a pistol. Short-barreled rifles, whatever else you want it to be. If your guys are good with that system, then heck yeah, keep rocking it, right? That's the way it should be. All right, but yeah, I think I'll end it off here with the BP-12. And again, as I mentioned multiple times throughout this video, I do want to hear from you guys. Let's keep this a nice constructive discussion, because the moment that I start seeing, hey, you know, why would you ever do this? That's stupid or whatever else, especially to other people that are commenting. Yeah, here, bye. We don't need that. Especially in the firearms community, I think it's best to start building people up instead of tearing each other down. So let's be nice out there, okay? Play nice, kids.